Okay, keep your panties on.
I'm pregnant.
What?
Nobody can say nothing bad about Tony Danza. Or Taxi or Who's the Boss, nothing you do.
Another week, another toast. We'll start with Tube Talk.
Oh, Rusty is bumping Tony from behind. Holy cow, Tony flips his car.
Think about that for a moment now.
Kiss my fat.
Have you heard? Watching sexy shows will make you spawn something. In a highly publicized pediatrics journal study, teens who watch shows with increased sexual content are twice as likely to become pregnant. Shows used in the study include Sex and the City and 90210. Raunchy stuff, unless you're this girl, Rally's commercials do it for her.
I've been having sex since I was 11 years old, with over 30 different guys. I even had sex for a double cheeseburger with bacon. It's all about fast money, baby.
Love that clip. In other news, Tony Danza used to be on TV, and thanks to the magic of the internets, an old clip of him is in heavy rotation after being featured this week on Funny or Die. You see, Tony doesn't know his audio feed is going live to this news anchor. Hey, Tony, tell us how you feel about being on this TV news program.
I don't want to do this.
Tony.
I don't even be part of the local news. How exciting. Right after murder and mayhem and the rescue in California, Tony Danza. I'm so excited.
When Tony Danza is questioning your contribution to television, I'd contemplate my chosen profession. Hey, there's always online video. They'll let anybody do that. Other stuff. 50 Cent has an apprentice-esque show coming soon. It has nothing to do with music, so they're sticking it on MTV. And ER and Jurassic Park mastermind Michael Crichton passed away. And Fox dumped the long-running King of the Hill, saying its impressive ratings cause it to not fit in with the network's other program. Fear not, though, a bidding war has already ensued for the show. Next up, the real world. A plump, steamy smattering of flicks hits theaters this weekend, starting with Role Models. Someone covered enough of Sean William Scott's shifts at Applebee's to allow him to star in this one, alongside Paul Rudd. It's a film about a pair of bachelors whose trouble with the law leads to mandatory community service with a group of children. That sounds perfectly safe.
Ronnie's one of our youngest. No one's lasted more than a day. But I think you're perfect because you're young and you don't want to go to prison.
What up, Ronnie?
I don't want to take my pants off.
What?
Oh, so we're not doing the pants off thing? Fine. Next up, Soul Man. Starring Sam Jackson and creepily Bernie Mac and Isaac Hayes both died recently. So a comedy seems proper, right? Sam and Bernie play former bandmates who reunite decades later for a tribute concert. Rock on.
We look good.
Ladies and gentlemen, the unforgettable sounds of the real deal.
If they ever expect to have a future.
My eye.
I'm sorry, man. I got on these tight slacks.
They'll have to reconnect with their past.
Oh, sorry. Didn't know you were back on me. Finally, we have Madagascar 2, Escape to Africa. Yes, the much-anticipated sequel to Madagascar 1, This Movie Blows, is finally on the big screen. This time around, the animals find themselves far from New York, Africa to be exact, to get acclimated with the land of their births.
Skipper, look.
Analysis.
It looks like a small incandescent bulb, designed to indicate something out of the ordinary, like a malfunction.
Right. Rico, manual.
Mm-hmm.
Problemo solved.
Nothing funnier than a plane crash. Who's with me? Oh, right. Next up, stargazing. Perhaps you heard Barack Obama won the election.
Really?
Yep. But there's this nasty rumor going around that he thumped McCain by like nearly 200 electoral votes. Not true. One man, this guy, made it happen. Sean P. Diddy Combs' vote, according to him, is the only one that matters. The AP caught up with the song Ripper Offer on election day, and he told him, quote, "I feel like my vote was the vote that put him into office. It was down to one vote, and that was going to be my vote." If your vote was the only one that mattered, we'd all be listening to mediocre music formed by stolen beats. zing. Also, we showed you last week how that reporter laughed in Joaquin Phoenix's face when he said he was leaving acting behind. Well, this week, the Walk the Line star gave a very special farewell to his dyslexic friends. Either that or he's just a freaking moron. And Simon Cowell, American Idol man boobs judge, is a liar. Why? Well, he told the Daily Mirror that for now he's off women, which implies that he was once on them. Yeah, that thing doesn't count. I said women. On the same note, Jamie Presley of My Name is Earl has split from her midget, and this guy kind of looks like Katie Holmes. That's it. Another toast gone by. There's always more at toastedrav.com, like our attempt to become urban ninjas. Didn't go so well. Thanks for dropping by. I'll see you next week.